Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. About 14 months ago, I had an idea. An idea which would enable me to invite world-class organists into the BIS music room to play a world-class organ online for you. Over the past year or so, and from the help and generosity of the BIS community, I am overjoyed that that idea is now a reality. What I have behind me here is one of the finest house organs in the entire world. Such a world-class organ deserves to be played by world-class organists. So, to inaugurate this wonderful instrument, I am so excited to announce an organist who's been organist at St. Paul's Cathedral, Westminster Abbey, Westminster Cathedral. He was the winner of the St. Albans Organ Improvisation Competition. He's been the president of the Royal College of Organists. Organists don't come much better than this. He is one of my heroes. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to the BIS Music Room, Martin Baker.
Thank you. Good evening. It's wonderful to be here. A big thank you to Richard for his kind introduction. And I'm having a wonderful time playing this new console and very privileged to be playing the first public recital on it. And what better way to start than with Bach's Passacaglia? It seems to me a kaleidoscope of the experience of life, and almost impossible to believe that it was written by a young Bach. We're moving on, staying with the early theme and staying on the same wonderful organ at Rotterdam, to Sweelinck's variations on Mein junges Leben, My Young Life is Close to Its End, a rather sad theme, and in the six variations there's plenty of evidence of that, but also of Sweelinck's characteristic digital dexterity and a bubbling of Dutch joy underneath it all.
Thank you.
So from that wonderful Sweelinck, we turn the clock forward a couple of centuries, and one of Widor's late symphonies, the whole symphony, the Ninth Symphony, known as the Symphony Gothique, it was played first of all by Widor in 1895 on the wonderful Cave École in Saint-Ouen in Rouen, a huge Gothic building. And we're very lucky that we have that very organ available to us this evening. So the kinds of sounds I'll be using, the acoustic and so on, is pretty much as this symphony was meant to be played in or on. Again, it's a darkness to light symphony, and although the title Gothic doesn't hint at it, it's about the birth of Christ. It's Advent to Christmas. So in the four movements, we progress from the dark C minor chaos in movement one through a little respite into the beautiful Andante sostenuto of the second movement, a demonic scherzo in the third movement, which surely was the inspiration for Dupré's fugue in G minor, which is very similar, but Widor got there first. And into that is introduced, the first time, I believe, in a Widor symphony, some Gregorian chant. It's the introit for Christmas Day, Puer Natus Est. And it comes in a rather kind of angular and angry pedal entry. Once the scherzo's over, though, Puer Natus becomes the main theme of a set of variations which form the last movement. And Widor's harmonic language takes a very different turn here. It doesn't sound like the Widor you know. And that's because he was adapting himself to the nature of the chant. And very unusually, the last movement ends in a quiet glow of C major, having reached a wonderful climax. And that's totally in keeping with the Feast of Christmas and with Gregorian chant, which is always beautifully shaped, an arch shape, and ends quietly.
wonderful symphony.
I got a breath now.
A wonderful symphony, the way it builds, builds right up towards the end, and then just takes it away, doesn't it?
Yeah, it floats off into the distance.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. After all that sort of angst and sadness.
And to finish this evening's concert, an improvisation. I'm going to pick up, I think, on the Christmas theme of the Widor and just play around a little bit with this wonderful organ from Dudelange, which I don't know. Richard has set up the organ for me, and I'll just pull out some stops, improvise, see where it all goes, and hopefully it will sound a little bit Christmassy at times, and perhaps even have a theme that you recognise. Thank you.
Wow. What a treat that was. Martin, thank you so much for your colourful, expressive and virtuosic playing. That was just amazing. Thank you so much indeed. I really hope that you've enjoyed the organ recital tonight, and I also hope that you are enjoying the Beauty and Sound 2021 Winter Organ Festival. One more video to go tomorrow, Virtual Church, live from here. If you are enjoying content here on Beauty and Sound, please do consider supporting the channel via any other links on the screen right now. Your support and your help enables me to invite world-class organists just like you've heard this evening. If you'd like me to invite your favourite organist, your hero, please do let me know who you would like to see on this channel, and you never know, that might become a reality. Good night, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed today's recital. Happy Christmas to you all. Stay safe, take care, and until next time, I will say cheerio. Good night. Goodbye. That's the...
Are they strictly not... They are strings, yeah?
Yes. They're all strings, yeah.
Gosh, yeah. It does the Abbey organ song. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. There's already a stop not working here. Sorry.
What is it?
The flute 8.
let's just try those.
Help his organ scholars and everything, which I'm really enjoying doing. Oh,
that's cool.
And I do a bit of chant for him and all that kind of stuff.
So you do actually go and play for him in keyboard?
Occasionally, yes.
Do you?
I'm just enjoying doing, you know. Yeah, yeah. Their organ scholar said to me, made me laugh, and said, "Hey, Martin," he said, "you know, you were Master of Music at Westminster Cathedral for 20 years, but you've recently been Senior Organ Scholar of Keys Doors, Cambridge."
Right, I think I'll sign off there. Right, Richard, I've waffled away.